Maybe you're one of those that says you should never even clean your ears. Excess wax can accumulate sometimes and make hearing difficult. At the same time, your ears usually do a good job cleaning themselves and don't need any extra care. The only reason you should clean them is to soften or remove earwax from the outside of your ear canals. And if you're going to do that, you'll need to know how to do it carefully. In today's video, we'll talk about some tricks and tips to keep your ears clean and healthy. Subscribe to our channel so that you don't miss our videos in future. Also, hit the bell icon to get notified every time we upload one. Let's get started. Why do we have earwax? The reason we feel tempted to clean our ears is because of that substance called cerumen, commonly called earwax. Earwax, or cerumen, is a self-cleaning agent your body produces. It collects dirt, bacteria, and other debris. It's normal for your body to produce it, and it actually helps protect and lubricate your ears. If you didn't have earwax, your ears would probably be itchy and dry. It even has antibacterial properties, which means your ears are self-cleaning. Earwax is like a filter for your ears, keeping out harmful things like dirt and dust, and trapping them so they don't go deep inside. When you chew and move your jaw, you help move old earwax out of the ear canal to the ear opening. That's where it usually dries up and falls out. But earwax isn't formed in the deep part of your ear canal. It's made in the outer section. So the only reason you'd have an earwax blockage up against your eardrum is because you tried to clean your ears with a cotton swab or something like it, and pushed the wax in deeper. Diseases caused by excessive earwax. Symptoms. Signs and symptoms of earwax blockage may include earache, feeling of fullness in the affected ear, ringing or noises in the ear, tinnitus, decreased hearing in the affected ear, dizziness, cough. Signs and symptoms could indicate another condition. You may think you can deal with earwax on your own, but there's no way to know if you have excessive earwax without having someone, usually your doctor, look in your ears. Having signs and symptoms, such as earache or decreased hearing, doesn't necessarily mean you have wax buildup. It's possible you have another medical condition involving your ears that may need attention. Wax removal is most safely done by a doctor. Your ear canal and eardrum are delicate and can be damaged easily by excess earwax. Don't try to remove earwax yourself with any device placed into your ear canal, especially if you have had ear surgery, have a hole, perforation, in your eardrum, or are having ear pain or drainage. Children usually have their ears checked as part of any medical examination. If necessary, a doctor can remove excess earwax from your child's ear during an office visit. Many people never need to clean their ears. Sometimes, though, wax can build up and affect your hearing. When earwax reaches this level, it's called impaction. This means earwax has completely filled your ear canal and it can happen in one or both ears. If you have impaction, you may experience symptoms like aching in the affected ear, fullness or ringing in the ear, impaired hearing in the affected ear, an odor coming from the affected ear, dizziness, a cough. You may be more likely to develop excess wax if you use hearing aids or earplugs. Older adults and people with developmental disabilities are also at higher risk. Your ear canal's shape may make the natural removal of wax difficult. How to clean your ears safely? The safest way to remove wax buildup from your ears is to visit your doctor. At your appointment, your doctor can use special instruments, like a cerumen spoon, forceps, or suction device, to clear the blockage. Many offices also offer professional irrigation. If you choose to try to remove wax at home, the following are the safest methods to try on your own. Damp cloth. Cotton swabs may push wax deeper into the ear canal. Use cotton swabs only on the outside of your ear, or, better yet, try wiping the area with a warm, damp washcloth. Earwax softener. Many pharmacies sell over-the-counter ear drops that soften wax. These drops are typically a solution. They may contain mineral oil, baby oil, glycerin, peroxide, hydrogen peroxide, saline. Place the specified number of drops into your ear, wait a certain amount of time, and then drain or rinse out your ear. Always follow the instructions on the package. Call your doctor if your symptoms continue after treatment. Lifestyle and home remedies. If your eardrum doesn't contain a tube or have a hole in it, these self-care measures may help you remove excess earwax that's blocking your ear canal. Soften the wax. Use an eyedropper to apply a few drops of baby oil, mineral oil, glycerin, or hydrogen peroxide in your ear canal. Use warm water. After a day or two, when the wax is softened, use a rubber-bowled syringe to gently squirt warm water into your ear canal. Tilt your head and pull your outer ear up and back to straighten your ear canal. When finished irrigating, tip your head to the side to let the water drain out. Dry your ear canal. When finished, gently dry your outer ear with a towel or handheld dryer. You may need to repeat this wax softening and irrigation procedure a few times before the excess earwax falls out. Earwax removal kits available in stores also can be effective at removing wax buildup. Ask your doctor for advice on how to properly select and use alternative earwax removal methods. If your problem isn't serious, but you do feel like you have too much earwax buildup, you can gently clean the outside of your ears. Just use a washcloth. You also can try putting a few drops of baby oil, hydrogen peroxide, mineral oil, or glycerin in your ear to soften the wax. Besides cotton swabs or any other small or pointy objects, don't use air candles to clean your ears. Studies show they're not effective and they can even cause injury. When to see your doctor, feelings of fullness in the ear, reduced or muffled hearing, and earache. They may also signal another medical problem, like an infection. Your doctor can look inside of your ears to determine if your symptoms stem from wax buildup or something else. The signs of ear infection in adults include pain in the middle ear, fluid drainage, impaired hearing. Ear infection symptoms typically develop rapidly. If you notice pain and drainage from your ears, don't try to treat it on your own. Make an appointment with your doctor as soon as possible to get a proper diagnosis and, if necessary, medication. If you experience earwax impaction more than once per year or have certain risk factors, tell your doctor. You may want to schedule routine professional cleanings every 6 to 12 months. How to protect your ears. Beyond keeping your ears clean, follow these tips to protect them and ensure good hearing for years to come. Don't insert small objects into your ears. You shouldn't put anything smaller than your elbow inside of your ear canal because it can cause injury to your eardrum or wax impaction. Limit your exposure to loud noises. Wear protective headgear or earplugs when the noise gets too loud. Take periodic breaks from using your headphones and keep the volume low enough that no one else can hear your music. Don't raise the volume in your car's sound system up too high either. Hope you guys liked the video. Share your thoughts in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, please do so and hit that notification bell. See you in the next video.